Hello and welcome to Eye on the Money, the television show that gives you insights into how to improve your financial well-being as well as make your money work for you. I'm Ingrid Nantege, and today on the show we talk about demystifying the concept of money. Now, the subject of money is very emotive, controversial, and emotional, especially among Africans. Money is the number one cause of conflicts among families and institutions, both private and government-sponsored. Beyond that, money is also one of the biggest creators of stress and anxiety in the world. However, by changing one's perception and mindset around money, one changes their results. On the show today, I'm joined by personal finance coach and author Chacha Nyaigoti Bichanga to help us discuss the key to demystifying money as well as changing one's perceptions in order to create a whole new paradigm shift and different results when it comes to money. Now, welcome to the show, Chacha. I'm very happy to have you today to talk about demystifying this concept of money.
Thank you to Ingrid. It's my pleasure to have you on board on this show.
Brilliant. Now, Chacha, even as we're here to talk about money today, just help us understand. Money still remains something that is so complex. It's something we interact with on a daily basis, but I don't know if a lot of people can say they have a full, proper grasp or understanding, you know, about what money is. That's why we see a lot of people having so many issues when it comes to managing money. But from a professional and expert point of view, help us demystify this big elephant in the room. What is money all about? Like, if you were to help us understand it simply.
Yeah, thank you, Ingrid, for that powerful introduction. I would like to say that money, one of the most historic inventions of man in his civilization is money. That money is over 3,000 years old. But this item or commodity or concept called money, as you have said, is the most controversial, most sensitive, and the most misunderstood concept. And is money is the number one cause of conflict in families, in institutions, as you have said, both government and the private, in churches, in organizations. So the million-dollar question is, why do many people experience problems with money? It boils down to basically what is money all about. Here we are going to look at various perspectives of looking at money. And money first, the basic concept that we have learned even in school, money is a medium of exchange. It is a social contract. That now, this concept called money, which now can come in various forms. Remember, money has evolved over time. We started with barter trade. Goods were exchanged for goods. If you have a cow, I need a goat, we exchange. And you realize the value for that kind of exchange was not really absolute in essence. Then money evolved into the use of metallic coins, the silver, gold. It evolved into the use of paper currency. And nowadays we talk of digital currency, where we have electronic transfer of money. In fact, we do many transactions using mobile apps, using M-Pesa, and so on. So money in that case is a social contract as a medium of exchange. Mm. It is something now that now in the country of Kenya, we have what we call Central Bank of Kenya. So money, secondly, is a legal tender issued by the Central Bank of Kenya, which is mandated to print money. Remember, no other institution is mandated to print money. So CBK issues what we call a legal tender. That this item or concept or commodity we call money is illegal in structure. If you misuse, let's say, a shilling or a note, you tear it into pieces and you are caught, you'll be liable for imprisonment and a huge fine. Thirdly, now, money is a form of measurement, economic measurement, that we use money to determine the value. For example, if I have 1,000 shillings note, I can use that, for example, to buy. I can buy, for example, I can buy a shirt. I can use it to buy some groceries. So meaning that money is an economic measure that we use when we are buying and selling. And as we have said, it's a legal tender, which has certain values that are agreed upon. Then when we move to the fourth concept of money, the meaning that money is a store of value. How is it? We are moving beyond money being a medium of exchange, money being a legal tender, being an economic unit of measurement, to a store of value. For example, if I have my 1,000 shillings note, I can use it, for example, to buy shares. Mm-hmm. Let us say I can use them to buy Equity, Safaricom, KCB, or any other shares in the Nairobi Securities Exchange. For example, if I buy 100 shares using 1,000 shillings, 100 shares of Safaricom, therefore the value is in the shares that are bought, which means now money has changed from being that value of 1,000 has given me 100 shares, which is now stored over time and can appreciate, and I can sell them once the shares, for example, increase in value. So money is a store of value. We can use money to buy assets that increase in value. We can use money to buy a real estate, to buy apartments. Mm-hmm. You can use money to do something, or you can use money to start a business. So the value of money is stored in what you have used it for, and especially if it's going to generate some income or increase in value. Lastly, money is an enabler. Money is an idea. This is the most important concept, because money goes beyond the currency which circulates, which gains value or reduces value according to the inflation rate in the country. So as an idea, money transforms our lives for the better. Meaning that if you have an idea, you can start it and you attract money. For example, even the idea of M-Pesa, it was an idea that somebody came up with and which Safaricom took over. And now M-Pesa has revolutionized the way we transact, the way we buy and sell in the whole of Africa, in the whole of the world. So money itself, now we move beyond the commodity that we use as a medium into an idea that you can come up with. For example, you can come up with an application. This application, you can sell it to people. When they use, when people use a certain application, call it a mobile application, you get a certain percentage of the transaction. Say you can get 1% of every transaction. So as an idea, you see, that idea will attract what we call money, and it will make you rich or wealthy. And in this case, money is a concept that transforms our lives for the better. Mm-hmm. And with that, now the question is, why then do people misunderstand this concept of money? Why do we have many financial problems, even especially among the employees? You find a week after payday, many employees, they run broke. Some have worked long until retirement, but they have nothing to show for it. Even some who are retirees want to start a business after retirement, meaning that the idea of making money ought to have been learned earlier and put into practice. So the cause of the financial problems we have in our society is lack of personal financial education. It is because of financial illiteracy. And with that, the way we are brought up conditions our mind in terms of the beliefs, in terms of the ideas that we have about money. So if you want to trace the root causes, go back to the beginning, your childhood days. And this brings in now the myths and the facts about money.
Chacha, before we even get into the myths and facts about money, I would really like to interject and ask about, you brought in a very important aspect where you said how we relate to money really stems to lack of either financial literacy or lack of proper knowledge on finance, and it really somehow stems back to how we were brought. Now, just to put it into context, in the African society, we see a situation, even right from when you are young, the way money is perceived, children don't really are not involved in decision making when it comes to money. There's a way in which when families are handling money, it's not too involving for the children. Our curriculums, a lot of the times, don't even include financial literacy. With that said, then, what does this beg the question in terms of tweaking things around and how we interact with money right from when we're young and also maybe in our school upbringing for our children? How important is it to incorporate all this just so, you know, later in life, everyone has a better understanding and even probably which will translate into a better relationship with money?
Yeah, thank you for that kind of perspective that in our upbringing, the way our children are born and brought up, especially talk of if it's in the traditional kind of society, although now we are in the modern times, you find the way we are socialized or brought up within our families, within our neighborhood, the school systems that we attend, even the churches, the religious groups that we ascribe to, the mass media even. Without God, nowadays we have even Metropole TV, which is business oriented. These agents of socialization have not conditioned or taught our children, who now are adults like us, the right kind of beliefs and ideas about money. So as a society, even as a government, we need to have a curriculum. The children, when they report to school, they need to be taught basics, basic life skills, for example, about money, how to maybe save, the importance of saving, how to the value of money in, for example, buying things that increase in value. Bit by bit, these children grow up now understanding that money is not evil, as we are meant to believe, some of those myths. So even our parents, as parents also, we are supposed to teach children about money. But remember, Ingrid, you cannot teach what you don't know. You cannot give what you don't have. So it starts with ourselves. We need to re-educate ourselves about the concept of money as an idea that can transform lives, as a store of value. Even our religious institutions also, they do a good role, but they should not emphasize on the negative aspect of money. Money, okay, that money is the root cause of evil. Well, but what about lack of money? Is it also the cause of evil that tempts people to go and steal, to kill for money? Yeah, the mass media also should come in handy. The society in general plays a crucial role in teaching people, enlightening them about the positive aspects of money. And this, in fact, the myths I've talked about, these are ideas, beliefs that we have learned from childhood over time, however outlandish, however insensitive they are, until we have accepted them as factual truth, when in essence they are not true. So thank you. Now that brings us to the myths now about money. The
brilliant. Chacha, I'm so sorry. I feel like this is such a loaded conversation. So please allow me, just so we don't have a disconnect, now that you've explained to us what needs to be done in terms of just from the point of raising a child, how it should be included in conversations in schools, I would like us to pick up the myths right after the break. And remember, you're watching Eye on the Money. You can also be a part of the conversation by sending your feedback to our social media handles at Metropole TV KE on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. We'll be right back right after this break.